Monaco. Very expensive. $200 a night to stay in the hotel. Have a look at some, let's do some window shopping. Okay. Now watch there. 19,950 francs. Well, here we are in Monaco. Monte Carlo. It's 10 o'clock in the morning. And we're just gonna go down for breakfast. This is the hotel room right on the water. There's the restaurant. Beautiful city, but you can't see it from here. There's a cruise ship.
Oh, we can't see that. Thank goodness. Just finishing breakfast here. Not a bad little coffee shop. I'll just go down to the balcony and we'll take a look. This is such a nice little garden in this inexpensive hotel. And maybe we just got a great deal. Wow. Overlooking the water. That's a nice sheltered little area overlooking the Mediterranean. It's beautiful. Even the trains that go by every 2 seconds blowing their horn doesn't really bother us. Further down in the Jardin, we see the beautiful views. Now this place played an important role in the First and Second World War. As you see, it's totally fortified with barbed wire and other types of protective devices like trees and stuff. And does it surprise you? There is another beach right in our midst. Right. Okay. Should be about enough. Goodbye. Or hello. Or oops, it's 11. Okay. We'll just check that Mediterranean view one more time and we will say goodbye. Oops. I guess I just wanted to show you this view one more time. Show you that ocean liner that's parked just off the coast of Monaco. This is where we, last year, had a stop right on the coast. And our family had a little tour of this area. And we're back 1 year later. Or a year and a bit later. Wow, nice. Mark wanted me to give you a show you this castle up in the hill. It's an ordinary castle. Up in an ordinary hill. Goodbye.
Monte Carlo! Oh, maybe we don't need it. Oh, yeah. Well, come on. Nice dog. Goodbye, Monaco, Monte Carlo. Here we are in Italia, in Mentini. Boca Cappuccini. Read your dick. Italy. Italy. Where are we?
Italy.
Yeah, but where?
Savona.
Savona. Italia. Italy.
Non
Non credo perché sulla macchina qui poi ha tirato la leva per aprire la maniglia, ho visto che... Però fanno già una volta anche, Ciccio!
Okay, where are we? Speak.
We're in Cactulac. Other words, Campiago.
Where?
Campiago, Italy.
Yeah.
Or Campionogo.
Yeah.
Or Campi Pizza.
Or count pasta. Your chickens before they hatch.
Was that pizza, pasta, or rigatoni?
No, that was rigatoni. That was rigatoni.
Mr. Torta and Lini.
No,
Lingui and Gini. And Sashi and Sasha.
And her sister, don't forget.
And her half-sister, Kasha.
Oh, no, no,
and
no.
Ketchup.
No, ketchup's not invited. Mustard.
Oh, you mean mustard.
Yeah, mustard, sorry. I forgot what vagina tree we're in.
And toast.
Toast?
That's twit. Okay, let's drop.
Well, here we are in spaghetti country. That's where we were this morning. You've just seen the footage.
What's that buzz?
Fuck, I thought, oops. Excuse the French, I thought it was my pager.
Ah, perfect. Beautiful click of a shutter and the advancement of film. Oh
Statue there.
I know from a lack of experience. Oops.
Yeah, nice one.
No
youths allowed in here.
Coralie, Coralie, Coritas. Tameritas and Kadamadas. Nice call. Right on.
Say it again.
Our ship was a Radisson Diamond crew parked right out there. We took one of these type of boats and brought us here. We did a lot of shooting around here. No real classics. But I intend to make up for it this time. I know what has gone on. I could have put the filming camera. This time I've got oodles of black and white film for the most colorful.
Oodles of noodles?
Goodles. And I see a classic as we speak in Z. And I don't think I'm wrong. And they're right. And our party animal has a good little snap. Remember, snatching this, snatching that. Slideshow of this, slideshow of that. We have a slide, we have a show.
We're in Mavatova, Italy. Where are you going?
think that's right. Let's just take a look.
Oh, sorry, Moscowini?
Anything to give away where we might be? No, not yet.
May give it away. Okay, just unload our luggage there, please. From the bike to the boat to the hotel. He likes it so much. Oh man, save your film. There'll be so much to shoot. Now that is a very common sight in Venezia. And that is birds flying over gondolas. You know, it's very noisy. I hope Mark will put this to some Venetian music. Now this is a very famous bridge. There are a lot of classic shots. Does Michelangelo have any work here? I'm not sure.
I don't know.
I would imagine he has a few paintings. Hey, Monsieur Gondola. Veteneria. Now if you're lying on me to sing, go get it. Something's happening to this dude. Not very lively, this guy. Where's his hat? Mark wants me to keep shooting all this stuff. Wait until he sees the real stuff. I'll get some shots. That is your classic. Oh, crap. We're just parking. Is anybody bored yet of these shots? What is happening, or will be happening, Africa. Yeah. Mm. Yeah. It's a good school and my architecture. It's Greek architecture. I guarantee you it is quite famous. I've seen on a few posters anyway. And we are nearing our destination, which is Piazza San Marco. Here's the Italian fleet of... Oh! Listen closely. Listen closely. Who's disturbing the peace there? Okay, now, where is that boy? Where is that boy? With his light load. Oh, he's resting. Got a few stuff there or something. Okay, let's grow.
This is in Venice.
Dirty?
Tell that little dick to move his head out of the way.
Thank you.
is the leaning tower of pizza pizzeria. Artist at work.
See what happens there. Your Kathy here. Get the sky in.
Which guy? Oh, the sky.
The guy. The guy in the sky. His name is Yashuha.
Yashuha? I've even got the moon up on it. The Venice in the dark. A holy macaroni.
The boat of
hitting the pizzeria and burning it to a crust.
Ah, there's the skyline.
Oh, imagine, that would be great if it bolted now. There's a Venetian boat. Out on that.
It's a
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Crying in the sun is all that I have won. Because Okay. Not too ruggedly.
Who flung down? Who flung? She asked me, tell me, stick it right up to the glass. You know what you're doing. And they're not. Who flung down?
I don't know, but whoever it was a good shot.
Here, Mr. Hu Fangdang.
I got that already like a million times over. Hu Fang?
Okay, here's some good Venetian food. Bulgogiana also.
Yeah, I'll take two of those. On Kornabunkov. Or on the cob. Is it Halloween or something? Beautiful. I bought one of those last time I wasn't here. This is a view of our room. It's a nice room. A cozy room. And we'll take a view of the toiletry items. Yeah, right. That's in the room.
Here's the potty. Look, it's a transportable toilet.
Nice pot. Let's zoom in.
Every time we use the tissue paper, we have to rinse it out.
That's okay, though. What do you want? The Taj Mahal Knoll. Here's a bed. There's a lamp. Okay, here we are in Slovenia. Oh, what do we have here? Darko, What are you doing here in Slovenia?
Slovenia. These are fix.
This is the fix, yes.
This is Malino. It's out of these berries, right?
Oh, really? Raspberries.
Oh, it's made because we have a lot of them.
Wow. This okay to eat?
Yes.
Figs are the best here.
You can take all them.
Do you know? Oh, shoot.
Well, Keith, explain. Keith, explain the deal in front of us. Well, that was the trumpet. Well done. Tony, explain.
Yeah.
What's this in front of us?
This is Ljubljana.
Lubli who?
Castle.
Right.
This is center of town.
Right.
At the moment we are here.
Right.
And
that's the local swimming pool.
Yeah, this is summer swimming pool.
Yeah, it's full of water right now.
You can use it only today because it rained.
Okay, now to look at the real city. What's this called? City Square?
Yeah.
Looks more like City Circle.
This is center of town.
Is it? Where's the castle up there?
Yeah. Real castle and this castle.
That's that castle.
Here is the river.
What's the river?
Ljubljanica.
What's it called?
Ljubljanica.
Ljubljanica.
Yeah.
That's a real, real toe twister, that one.
And this is Tromostovje, which means three bridges. There.
See, in America they call that tripod.
Looks okay.
Pretty snifty. Oops, hold on. Looks pretty good. Cairo. Date. Paris.
Do you need battery?
No, Paris. I'm just.
I have here one.
No, the time has changed. Paris time. September the 3rd. Ljubljana. To know where was Syria.
Which one does this one go on? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, now here.
I don't believe you.
Mark is the expert chess player. He wanted a challenge.
I swear, I've been playing for 10 years. I don't believe you. I swear, I promise.
Don't ask me that it's green or it's king.
You know what? He wanted to play Borut again. Borut was the national champion of Slovenia. Came in 21st in the world.
I like a challenge.
And he wanted to have a game.
Oh, this is that sex thing. I instantly have to go for jiggy jiggy.
Yeah, this is sex. Yeah. We play him with this because I didn't go on all trip.
Right.
And all trip cost about 75 Deutschmarks.
Yeah.
Then I negotiated with him both. He went to me for 30 Deutschmarks.
Wow, that's good.
So it was 75 per person.
So is the king on the right square?
Huh?
Is it correct?
No, it's not correct. This is correct, but I know that you joke with me, and I don't believe you.
I haven't played for 10 years, I swear.
So why would you challenge a national chess champion to a game?
Why a challenge? You know what TV turns out on.
This is the Roman town.
Yeah?
In the coast.
Here we are in the Italian Alps, just left Ljubljana, capital of Slovenia. It's quite beautiful. Why should I? When I got all this beautiful scenery. There's Keith and Tony and his wife, Eva.
Nice.
And we're in between tunnels in the Alps. There's one tunnel. There's the other tunnel. Quite magnifico. Okay, we have been waiting for commander's sign to continue to see the winner of the day.
Yeah.
See? Po 5 sekund, ne?
Да, Yes, it's Deklica.
Let's play back that video.
This is where they start. Keith and I are going to have a go. Oh, there's... And the point is to get as close to that circle as he can. Oh. He got it right on the hole. Yes.
Coming in for a landing. Look at that beautiful landing. And he kills himself. There is a nice shot. Look at that. Look at that. Here they come. Yay! Bravo, Telia! It's one of the astronauts from the Apollo space daredevil craft. It's Kathy. Sadie. Andor, what do you have to say for yourself? Not much, eh?
I'm just waiting for... if they allowed me to go there, then I will try to make some movies from the air.
And then we'll get you coming down, crashing.
Yeah, after this I'm not scared. I'm just scared about how to make the best movies. Landing is not my problem.
You know, I agree with that. And Ava, do you agree?
No.
No, she doesn't? And here's one of the men from GLAAD.
Man, he's got a gland.
One Marky Jammer, Go Jammer. Okay, here comes the Harley. Oh, look at that. Look at that view. There he goes into the sunset. Or into the woods, whatever. He thought this would be a great shot. Actually, it's not too bad.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this. Oh, a double. Double trouble. Vene, vene. Who's that? Not moving too quickly. Get some action here, Marky. I bet he doesn't know that I'm snooping it. Therefore, he's going very slowly. Running over the poor kids. Okay. And... stop! Stop! Let's just take a look.
He can't ride it. See, you can't tell I'm riding on the road there.
I know, that's a neat part about it. You know, let's get...
Okay, so here we are doing our first Wright Sisters. We're going to... fly! In the Italian Alps.
That was gonna wear on me. Holy
That's what we're supposed to be doing. Whoa, big dump! Here's Keith shitting himself just before he's going on his first maiden voyage. Turn around! Oh, my, it's okay, my telephoto is not strong enough. Run! Run! Hands up!
My hands are up.
Still you have too much.
No. Didn't push it up. Oh, well, that'll do me.
Hands up!
Run,
run!
Keith and Cleva lying in the grass.
How many hours are you in the air?
Wow.
Let's go right to the car.
Don't land.
Bye bye.
Don't land. Ooh, this is
Vishka. Wow.
Because it's, and still, we have a very nice weather. That's the most important thing. Because on Friday, we're not sure that the weather will be so good as it is.
In the Italian Alps, Monday morning, the 5th of September, one of the most beautiful places ever seen. Say howdy catch a Tory.
Snatching, we have here. Actually, this is a freaking great shot. That's a classic.
Mr. Levitus?
Yes.
Okay. Speak up.
A map just prior to the conclusion of the First World War. There you see the Austrian-Hungarian Empire. It's very large. Here you see Italy and its territories. Germany, Germany, Poland, French, France. So we're situated in Kovarid, which is one of the important fronts of the Austrian-Hungarian Empire and Italy. A lot of activity happened where we stand
in the First World War.
Awesome.
Okay. So, let's have a look at some.
Wow, look at these.
Shells here. And
these dudes.
All these people must have perished in the war. Oh, look, that's a bit of shrapnel right there, Keith. That's what happens at the end of that shell that's sitting out the front there.
Okay,
hold on, hold on. So 1926. Yeah. Yes, thank you.
There he is, Ernest. Shout out Ernest, farewell to arms.
Ernest Hemingway. Partisan uniform. Look at his SS uniform. Look at that.
This is Second World War.
Yeah. All happened right here.
one side, and Kulanik, Kern, Mirzliburg, and Odilburg on the other. The impassibility of the mountainous region and the few roads meeting in Kobarid give this little town a special importance.
In October 1917, this friendly place played an important part in the First World War, when the joint Austrian-German forces attacked the Italian troops and broke through the positions along the Sorcha front. And here we are already coming to the historical part this place once played, and thus gave its name to the breakthrough of the 12th battle on the River Sorcha.
The First World War broke out on the 28th of July 1914, and a little less than a year after the cruel experiences on the European battlefields, also Slovene territory was included in the war scene.
In the month of May of the year 1915, cannons roared for the first time along the Sorcha River. Italy opened a front of 600 kilometers towards Austria-Hungary, a front reaching from the mountain pass of Stelvio over the Tyrol, the Carniche Mountains to the Rombon in Slovenia, and then down to the River Sorcha and along the river to the sea. The civilian population was put to flight. The Italian army managed a slow breakthrough at all front lines and entrenched near Kobarid on the left river bank. A further advance was impeded by the mountain cone.
The idea of a breakthrough near Kobarid originally came from the Austrian-Hungarian side. After 11 offensives, the front was badly weakened, and a minor Italian attack would have been enough to make the defense in the Sorcha collapse. Acute lack of troops worried the commanders-in-chief of the Austrian-Hungarian army in their plans for a rescue offensive. Where to take the missing divisions from? The Austrian Emperor Charles I saw himself obliged to ask his ally, the German Emperor William II, for help. So Germany came rather unexpectedly in the theater of war on the River Sorcha in Slovenia. In September 1917, the German general Kraft von Dillmenzingen prepared a daring plan of attack under the codename Loyalty of Arms. This plan was made in the upper part of the Sorcha Valley, between Bolitz and Durmin, and had been prepared with new military tactics. It based on elements of surprise, on a daring choice of the mountain area, on a prompt combination of infantry and artillery, and a very much armed initiative on the part of officers and soldiers.
The 14th German-Austrian Army, counting 15 divisions under exclusively German command, was set up anew. Otto von Below was the supreme commander, Kraft von Dellmensingen, chief of staff. The offensive was planned to be started on the 15th of October 1917.
Movements of troops and transport of arms started under absolute secrecy. After the 20th of September, 2,400 trains and more than 100,000 railway carriages transported soldiers and the necessary material to the different collecting points near the front. The heaviest transport which was sent to this front by railway were 3,000 cannons of different calibers.
The second part of the troop movements was already somewhat more difficult. A great number of soldiers, weapons, tools, cattle and food still had to be conveyed to the front. But only very narrow and steep ways were available on which soldiers, lorries and mules crossed with great difficulties.
They reached the basin of bullets coming over the mountain passes of Predil and Bršić, over the mountains Komna and Köln, and over the passes of Škofja Loka and Sveta Lucia to the bridges of Turmin. The only railway connection from Jesenice to Sveta Lucia was only of limited help, as it had been damaged by the Italian artillery.
In something more than 4 weeks, the trying and complicated transfer of the 14th Army had succeeded.
Bad weather had concealed him from the Italian reconnaissance planes and intelligence services. The numerous reports on the preparations for an offensive did not really alarm General Cadorna, the commander of the Italian forces. On the 18th of September, he ordered the defense, but no urgent transfers within the drawing up of the whole 2nd Italian Army took place. The soldiers remained in the first trenches. The artillery was set up near the front line as well as the whole equipment. Closed to the front were also a cinema and a brothel.
The 2nd Italian Army, lined up along the River Sorcia, was under the command of General Capella. The area between the villages of Bovets and Svita Lucia were being defended by the four divisions of the 4th and 27th Corps. The 7th Corps was in the second defense line. Southwards, there were further nine divisions with the greatest artillery concentration. The 2nd Army disposed of more than 2,430 cannons. Its reserves were stationed near Palmanova, that is at a great distance from Tolmina, and still farther even from Bovets.
The Italian divisions in the Sorcia Valley were set up in three defense lines. The Corps under General Kraus, a little further away, the 3rd Bavarian Corps under General Stein, and to the south, the 51st Corps under General Berra, and the 15th Austrian-Hungarian Corps under General Scotti. Their aims were the old Austrian-Italian border and Friuli.
100,000 soldiers awaited further orders in the canteens, the shelters, and the trenches. They were cold, and only very few permitted themselves a little rest before the decisive day.
Things still seemed to be peaceful. It was drizzling, but further up in the mountains, it had begun to snow.
Wednesday, the 24th of October, 1917. 2 o'clock in the morning. Darkness, fog, rain.
Destructive shells and a shower of poisonous gas fell over the Italian artillery positions and headquarters. Gas and smoke spread over the battlefield. It was worst of all in the narrow part of the Sorcia Valley, at the foot of the mountain Janáček, where a brigade from Friuli was stationed. Deep in the mountain's rocks, the men were safe from shells. But there was no escape from the creeping death, from suffocation by poisonous gas.
6 o'clock in the morning. Things were comparatively calm, but after half an hour it went on again. At first with light artillery fire only from 7 to 8 a.m. But then all 2,000 cannons were brought into action. Worst of all were the last 50 minutes.
Dust and smoke concealed surprise and death in the entrenchments of the 4th and 27th Italian Corps. The violent attack destroyed telephone and telegraph connections. It was as if darkness had broken in. But the worst began at 8 a.m. when the infantry attacked. The 22nd Division and the Division Edelweiss raided and occupied Bovets. The 22nd Division continued its breakthrough in the direction of Jaga, where it was then held up by Italians around midday. In the afternoon, the advance was very much slow. Meanwhile, the Italians patrolled along the valley of Fucia to the mountain Stop.
The well-fortified Italian positions on the mountains Polonik, Vršić, Vrat, Krsko Pogorje, and Mrtvivr were surprisingly quickly taken by the 50th and 55th Divisions. Under the cover of darkness, they formed a circle on the slopes of these mountains. The withdrawal of the 43rd, 46th, and part of the 34th Italian divisions caused a great confusion, especially there where the river had to be crossed. At the same time as Bovets and Krsko Pogorje, the southern part of the Scissors near Tolmin, began to withdraw too.
The 12th Rifle Division made an interesting move.
beautiful Slovenia. Well, the Dracula. Tell them to sing a song. Tell them to sing a song. Sing a song. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we are in a place called Bled, Slovenia, near the Austrian border. That little church is on an island. Beautiful place. Yeah, we can see what they're doing in the bathroom.
Yeah, look, swan.
Good morning, Swanee. Take me down the Swanee River. You're so beautiful.
Oh, yes.
Out of film. Look at this area now. Wow. There we are in Bled. Still in Slovenia. I was here before. Here he comes for the bread. He's coming for the bread. Why, to scare him away? How tame these guys are. They like turisticos, I guess. Especially when turisticos have Big Macs on them. Oh, isn't that nice? He dipped his head in the sun. Mm-hmm. This is your scene of Bled. I took a rowboat here. Here's Marky getting his bread. Oh god, he looks pretty ugly this morning. Where is he? Oh, he looks very ugly this morning. Okay, where do you think we are now? Manitoba? No. But here we are in Austria. Is it ever nice here?
There's an ostrich, quick!
And there is an ostrich smoking a cigarette and holding a camera.
Yeah, right, bidding me.
Hey, Austria.
Ostriches.
Ostriches. You mean you're not the ostrich?
I'm not the ostrich.
Look at those bikers.
Bikes in the middle of that field.
Yeah, okay. Take your bike in the middle of the field. Let's just zoom in and see this scenery. Well, it's not bad for an ostrich. Sorry for that shake. Bye-bye. And our ostrich town.
No, we're not. We're in Swahiziland.
We're in Africa.
Is this Pussyville or Twill or Twal? Here we are in Afghanistan or wherever we are.
Oh, just let me do a little snack.
Jesus,
oh,
look at this, man.
This is a shot, eh?
In Austria, in the Alps,
Classico.
Like, my gotten Jungi, Bungi, Bungi, Jungi, Jungi.
Right there?
I think you can stick the bike somewhere else.
What, the crack?